Hi everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are going over the science behind the self-filling balloon. For this one, you'll need baking soda, vinegar, a plastic bottle, doesn't really matter what size, a balloon, a candle for a second demo, a cup, and a lighter, and for this one, you should have adult supervision. Now, the science behind the self-filling balloon is really the science behind the acid-base reaction between baking soda and vinegar. Baking soda, which is our base, its chemical name is sodium bicarbonate. Vinegar, which is our acid, the main ingredient here is acetic acid. When you mix baking soda and vinegar together, like most acid-base reactions, you get water and a type of salt. For us, when we mix sodium bicarbonate and acetic acid, we get water, our salt is sodium acetate, and we also get something special. We get carbon dioxide. That's the really important ingredient here. So to start our self-filling balloon, take your plastic bottle and pour just a little bit of vinegar in there. You don't need all that much, maybe like a third of a cup or so. Just like that. That's really all you need. And then take your balloon and fill your balloon with baking soda. I already filled this one with about 2 teaspoons of baking soda. Take that balloon and put it over the top part of your plastic bottle, making sure to get it down over the edge so that there are no leaks. All we have to do to start our chemical reaction is lift this balloon. Now, a chemical reaction just means that when you combine one or more ingredients, you get something different on the other end. It's like atoms going to a party and rearranging themselves. We can start our chemical reaction in 3, 2, 1. You can see those carbon dioxide bubbles. That's adding carbon dioxide to this balloon. We have a carbon dioxide balloon forming in front of us, getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Look at that, how cool. Our self-filling balloon. To start our second demo, you just need to light your candle. Just like that. And then we're gonna do the same acid-base reaction just in our glass. So take a little bit of vinegar, just like so. And go ahead and just toss some baking soda in there. Woo! Just like that. You can see the carbon dioxide bubbles forming. So I want you to get your candle and bring it close to your glass. And then 3, 2, 1, just do this. What happened there? Okay, so carbon dioxide in the same pressure and temperature is more dense than air, meaning it will sink when it's in air. You know how helium rises in air? Carbon dioxide sinks. So when we tipped our glass over, that carbon dioxide sunk onto the flame, displaced the air around that flame, and starved that flame of oxygen, which it needed to ignite. So we put out our flame with carbon dioxide. That is the science behind the self-filling balloon.